Hi, everybody. I'm Jeff, and I want to show you how to make your own dryer lint bucket to help heat your home with your clothes dryer. And this is not for gas clothes dryer. This is electric clothes dryer only. You can't pump the exhaust from a gas dryer into your house. It'd be carbon monoxide. So this is for electric dryer only into your house in the wintertime to help. So you need humidity in the air in your house. You'll be able to turn your thermostat down a little bit if you get your humidity in the house, say at about 55%. The humidity will hold the heat in the air. So when, say, your furnace shuts off, it doesn't get cold and drafty real quick. If there's humidity in the air, you've got that humidity, it'll hold the heat. So anyway, what they have on the market now is these small dryer vent buckets. I'm sure you've seen them. They're about like this square, okay? And they got a place to put your dryer vent hose in the top. And you fill them half full of water. Well, those things are just junk, okay? They don't work. I mean, they throw more lint out into the room than you can imagine. Plus, the water that you put in the bucket evaporates very quickly, and the next thing you know, it's tipping over on you. So what I've done is made a large version of that, and I've done this a long time ago, back in the 1980s. So this isn't anything new, and I'm sure there's other people out there that's made this, but this is very inexpensive to do. I just went to Home Depot and bought a 5-gallon pail, and I bought their lid, and it was about $4 for this and the lid. Then another thing I bought was what's called, I picked up at Home Depot, this is called a dryer dock. And what it is for 4-inch vent pipe, for dryer vent pipe, and I'll show you a side view of it. A twist unlocks. Okay, and we're going to use this for something different. Then I got two hose clamps, and I got the aluminum dryer venting hose. And this is 8 feet worth, and that's all you'd need. And this didn't cost me very much to get all of these. So I'm going to show you how this works. Now you can make this really quick, and it will cost you probably less than buying one of those little junky boxes for lint. And there's a couple of other things you do not want to do with an electric dryer. I used to be an appliance repairman for like 25 years. Never take a nylon and put over the exhaust pipe on a dryer and clamp it down to let heat into your house. What happens is that nylon will fill with lint very quickly, and instead it'll slow down the airflow coming out of your dryer. So say it used to take you a half hour to dry clothes, and now you got this nylon sock over the exhaust pipe on your dryer, and now all of a sudden it's taking 45 minutes to dry your clothes, and then it's taking an hour to dry your clothes. Well, what's happened is those nylon stockings are slowing down the airflow, the exhaust coming out of that dryer, and basically backing up all of the humidity inside the dryer. But it's a bad idea. Don't ever use nylon. You cannot slow down the airflow, the exhaust, out of any dryer. If you do, you will increase the time it takes to dry a load of clothes. They have another little deal that fits in your exhaust pipe. It's a plastic tube like this, a square box, and a little tiny screen on the front. And you flip it this way for the winter time, and it blows the heat into your house. Those don't really work very well. The screen in them fills up with lint right away, and it's a waste of time. So I come up with this, and I done this back in the 1980s, and I don't know if anybody else did it. It's just something I came up with myself. So I'll show you how you're going to start. It's real easy. This quick connect, or this dryer dock, this goes into the top of the bucket. And all you got to do is take yourself a felt marker and go to the center of the bucket. Go about the center. And I'm using real simple tools too. Just a flat black felt marker. There. And I got my hole. Next, All right, now next, what I've got is just my box cutter. This is a nice little Gerber box cutter I've got. This thing is cool. You'd like one of these. I open up boxes all the time, so I've got one of this little clip. Anyway, you can just use a utility knife, a drywall knife, a saber saw to go down here and cut this out. Anyway, I'm going to cut this out, and I'll put in the dryer dock. Okay, so this is how it looks. This is a little easier than what I did. I'm going to pop it apart, and there are three screw holes on the top of this, which is pretty cool. And all I'm going to do is I have three self-tapping screws, and I'm going to screw down into this, and that'll be it. If you want to screw these things down very tight, it'll strip it out. There you go, I got it screwed in. Little piece locks on there. Bang, locked in. Now you can put your dryer vent hose right to the top of this. Now for the exhaust, this is what I did. Okay, so now what I need to do is cut a whole bunch of vent holes around the outside edge of this bucket, and this is very important. We need a lot of airflow coming around the outside edge of this bucket. I got a 15/16 wood bit, but you can use a bigger one. Just don't go any smaller than this. And remember, don't put too few because you will slow down the exhaust on your dryer and it's going to take you a lot longer to dry clothes, so put in plenty. There you go. Just put one at each one of these little ridges, and now I'll go ahead and drill it out. There we go. We're all done. That's plenty of exhaust. Now what we're going to do is pretty much we're almost done. Just attach the hose to the back of the dryer and we're ready to go. Now the hose I'm using is this aluminum dryer vent hose. This is 4-inch stuff and aluminum. Don't use that white vinyl hose if you got it around. Matter of fact, that stuff is banned a lot of places because it catches fire. So they use this aluminum stuff, and this is 8 feet worth. So, and I bought my 2 4-inch clamps, and truthfully, I've probably got about $20 into this all together. And all of this stuff just comes from Home Depot. Okay, there we go. Got my hose attached to the bucket. You want to make sure it's nice and tight, like that. And then we can unlock it from the bucket. Is that nice? We'll go ahead and hook this up to the dryer. Okay, we got the other end hooked onto the exhaust of the dryer. And it's nice if you can put this vent bucket out in another room away from the dryer, but if you can't, you can't. Okay, now what I'm going to do, so there's one more thing I have left to do. There are several tabs on the top of this bucket, and that makes it kind of hard to unsnap and get it off. So what I do is I cut out every other one of these tabs, and it makes it easy to unlock it. Okay, you see what I did? I cut off every other locking tab off from this, so it's easy to take off. Now, all you do, fill this bucket half full of water, just halfway up. Snap the lid on. Use the dryer dock locked on. We're all done. Just turn your dryer on and dry like you normally do. All of the lint will blow down into the water and get trapped, and it won't come out into your room. Remember, don't do this with a gas dryer. You can get carbon monoxide poisoning to do that. You don't ever exhaust a gas dryer into your house. This is electric dryer only. Now, want to check the water once in a while. Keep the bucket about half full. When it starts getting all sort of nasty and full of lint, just pop the ring off, pop the lid off, take it out and dump it outdoors or wherever you want to dump it. Anyway, this is part of my series on how to cut your electric bill in half. And this here will definitely keep your furnace from running so much. You might as well pump the heat into your house. Plus, this is going to bring a lot of humidity into your house in the wintertime. Now, you don't want to use this in the summertime. Anyway, that's all there is to it. And I'm Jeff, and this is another part of my series on how to cut your electric bill in half. And I will show you how to heat and cool your home with an electric dryer.